Bobby Smith. Wingers are wide, and here comes Matt Naslin. Moving right in, he couldn't shove it by. Hextall knocked it down and then was able to clear. Out of the penalty box comes Sutter, offside against the Canadians, and now Hextall goes barreling out at one of the Canadians, hitting high and hard.
He wanted Chris Chelios as soon as Chelios came across the blue line. And that has to be that big mark that we talked about that's still riding on Chris Chelios' shirt from that hit on Brian Propp in game one. That's pretty well a signal that Ron Hextall has kissed the season goodbye. A minute and 37 seconds to go. The Flyers are down by two, and Hextall made a beeline for Chelios. And you know what was interesting about the play was that Chelios just came across the blue line intentionally to stop play, to end up with an intentional offside.
This would have been the point at which the Flyers would have wound up even strength with the Canadians, and Hextall might have been pulled in very soon for an extra attacker. Chelios escorted to the bench where the Canadians greet him, but there you see Ron Hextall frustrated, and now Dave Poulin is catching some hit from one of the Canadians, so Samuelson moves in, and we have a real powder keg brewing here.
You bet. Boy, did Chel Samuelson ever land a straight left on Bobby Smith, too. Acton and Ludwig move in now. Ludwig is a lot bigger and stronger than Keith Acton, so he pulled Acton into the pile.
Keep in mind now that Chelios has left, and if I count right, the Canadians have one fewer on the ice then the Flyers, and Hextall is being restrained by Gerard Gauthier from getting over towards Patrick Roy.
Hextall's also being challenged by Patrick Roy. Roy threw his stick down, took his mask off, and said, "You want me? Come over here." Now Paul Holmgren's leaning over the bench. It looked as if he was motioning to Ron Hextall to come over. As much as this would have been Paul Holmgren's style when he played, we have seen a lot more restraint from Paul Holmgren as a coach. So you'd have to think that this wasn't his idea.
Ladies and gentlemen, listen for me for just a second. Fire by the ice is settled. It has to be settled. Keep things in the stand. Keep things in the stand.
Two splendid teams with skill and heart and desire, and from that standpoint, it has been a storybook series. A couple of shutouts by Patrick Roy and strong defensive play by Montreal. Tremendous emotional surge for the Flyers in games one and five. And this type of thing should not be the final chapter in that storybook.
The old story of losing the war but trying to get a couple of battle wins in before it's all over. And hey, the Flyers play that kind of brand of hockey. But they kissed this one goodbye with Ron Sutter's penalty on Chris Chelios. And now have fully said goodbye to it with a minute and 37 seconds to go, down 4-2 to Montreal. That pride manifested itself in a pretty violent way late in this game. But Montreal will move on to play the Calgary Flames, barring a miracle. I mean, a minute 37 seconds to go. You got to think the Flyers are going to be shorthanded.
Yeah.
But they wanted Chelios, and they got Chelios. That was something that we had said in game one. He is going to be a marked man. So all of this couldn't have come as much as a surprise to Chris Chelios. And if anybody saw that hit on Brian Propp in game one, it was a vicious hit that deserved at least a major penalty, and that wasn't even called in game one. That was completely missed.
Mike Keane coming over to the Montreal bench. But you're right, all has been surrendered here. With they had a situation developing which could have at least given them a shot. They would have been an even strength and could have pulled Hextall in the last 100 seconds. two goals have been scored in that time, and it was still a possibility. But let's get the call.
Montreal penalty number 33, Patrick Roua. 2 minutes for leaving the crease, plus a 10-minute misconduct. Flyers penalty number 27, Ron Hextall, a 5-minute match penalty. Flyers penalty number 28, Kjell Samuelsson, a 10-minute misconduct. Time of the penalty is 18 minutes, 23 seconds.
So Hextall with a match penalty for attempt to injure on Chelios, and the outstanding minor that is up on the board now for the Canadians was assessed to Roua for leaving the crease. So neither team will be playing shorthanded here in the last minute and 37 seconds.